time it is? It's time for Whoop on Wheels with Fast Eddie and Big G right here on Whoop FM 99.9 and WhoopFM.com out there in the World Wide Web. Everybody's watching. Be careful, y'all. Come on, strap your babies in the car and hang on, because it's Fast Eddie and Big G right here with all your racing news right here on Whoop FM.
The controls tonight. He's under the control board, and he doesn't do it as much as I do, so I thought I'd let him do it. I got a lot of talking, gabbing to do here. Whoop on Wheels sponsored by L&B Appliance. Josh Taylor out there at 160 Durkee Road. Folks, you want some good appliances, go out there and see old Josh out there at L&B Appliances. Their slogan is family owned and operated, large enough to meet all your home appliance needs, small enough to appreciate your business. And they got great prices on all the top brands, the best selection of appliances and home furnishings, friendly and helpful knowledge salespeople, professional installation and service. They've got refrigerators, cooktop ovens, ranges, washers and dryers, living room. No, they don't have that now, I don't think he said. Their products are Amana, Electrolux, Frigidaire, Maytag, Whirlpool. Go by and see Josh at L&B Appliance, 339-3231 on 160 Durkee Road Northeast. And Perkins Yogurt, Roger Turpin. Go by and get many of the flavors that he's got. Also, he has diabetic ice cream for the diabetics like Big G and Fast Eddie. And I don't know why Billy Ocean's playing. I've got it playing here. But they're at 476-1668 at 3306 Key Street, right up from Monos, next door to Monos at Gondolier. And you'll hear Gondolier here shortly here. Probably right now in just a few minutes. Let's play some more commercials. We'll be right back.
I love hot dogs and I love pizza, but Pizza Hut's new Hot Dog Bites pizza? You went too far, Pizza Hut. Who puts 28 hot dog bites baked into the crust around a perfectly good pizza? Oh, so I get to eat pizza and also dip hot dog bites in the mustard sauce? You kidding me? I mean, it's just... Okay, that sounds awesome. You got me, Pizza Hut.
The new Hot Dog Bites pizza. Two tasty classics in one ridiculously delicious mashup. For a limited time, get a large one-topping Hot Dog Bites pizza for just $11.99. Only at Pizza Hut.
Limited time offer. Only available in original and pretzel crust flavors.
This is the sound that a mountain of biscuit dough makes when a rolling pin rolls it into flat, doughy planes. And if you listen really closely, you can hear the light sprinkling of flour onto biscuit dough. Hear that? That's a dough cutter carving out the circles that will rise into biscuits. This is made from scratch.
The Grilled Pork Chop Biscuit with fluffy egg and melting American cheese. Only at Hardee's. For a limited time at participating restaurants.
Our biscuits aren't made from scratch, like that cabinet you still haven't assembled, because the instruction manual is written in a code you need to be a member of the Swedish embassy to crack. No, our biscuits are made from scratch, like biscuit bakers wake up at the crack of dawn every morning to transform buttermilk and flour into a perfect golden brown mound of hot buttered biscuit. The made from scratch country fried steak and gravy biscuit, smothered in sausage gravy, only at Hardee's. For a limited time, participating restaurants.
Hey, hon. What you up to?
Oh, just looking online for something to do with the kids this weekend.
Well, I heard the weather's going to be great. Let's get outside and do something fun.
That sounds perfect. What'd you have in mind?
We make memories every day. Why not make ones that matter?
Come to the place where adventure runs wild, laughter is contagious, and the smiles are endless. Your ticket to fun is waiting for you and the whole family at Lake Winnie Amusement Park. For 90 years, families have created unforgettable memories at one of Chattanooga's best-kept secrets.
Wow, what a day. Are you ready to head home?
Well, can we ride the roller coaster one more time? I mean, I'm sure the kids would want to.
Of course. We wouldn't want to upset the kids now, would we?
Now open 7 days a week. One grandparent age 55 or older receives a free admission with one child admission under age 18. For more information, visit lakewinnie.com.
Let's make memories that matter.
When the Whoop on Wheels crew gets back from a long weekend spent in the infield in Talladega, their first stop in town is Surf's Up Car Wash. Surf's Up, 2575 Guthrie Street Northwest, located next to Cleveland Utilities, 790-5793. Surf's Up Car Wash, voted Cleveland's best 3 years in a row. Stop by and see Mike Royville and his gang at Surf's Up. Whoop on Wheels is proud to be sponsored by Emmanuel and the Gondolier. If you're in the Ooltewah area, stop in and see us at Emmanuel's. Phone number 910-0459. Emmanuel's, for all your Italian and Greek specialties, as well as the best pizza in town. Gondolier locations are at Okoy, 1603 Highway 64, Benton, Tennessee. That phone number, 338-7299. Stop in and see the fine folks at the Okoy Gondolier. And if you're in the Cleveland area, they're located at 3300 Keith Street, 472-4998. All items at Emmanuel and the Gondolier can be fixed for you to take home. Proud sponsors of Whoop on Wheels, Emmanuel and the Gondolier. When Big G and Fast Eddie need to make a pit stop for lunch, they head to Quiznos. Stop in and see Roger Patel and his crew at Quiznos Sub, 2151 Keith Street. Phone number 473-7976. For all your box lunches and catering needs, stop in and see the folks at Quiznos Sub. Quiznos. Toasty. El Cazador Mexican Restaurant, located at 2299 Keith Street. Phone number 790-0563. Lunch and happy hour specials daily. Stop in to the El Cazador Mexican Restaurant and try some of our new dishes, as well as our large vegetarian menu. El Cazador, for my money, the best Mexican restaurant in town. For all your pet grooming needs, see the staff at Happy Tails Grooming Salon. Happy Tails, located at 2251 North Okoy Street. Business hours are Tuesday through Friday, 8 to 5:30, Saturday, 9 to 5:30. For your appointment, call 339-5777. A full-service professional groomer. Happy Tails Grooming Salon. Come shaggy, leave happy.
Big G's trying to remember how to do the board here. I think I'm making him nervous. And we are at 25 minutes till 7 o'clock before Morgan Shepherd. The phone line, is the phone line open?
Yeah, there? It's open.
Phone line is there open if you want to make a phone call. We went through our spots here. Whoop on Wheels tonight at 7 o'clock. Morgan Shepherd, Xfinity Series. And Big G, you're not recording this, are you?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you. At 7:30, we got Frank Kimmel, and you got a phone call.
Yep. Go ahead, caller, you live on Whoop.
Hey, Big G.
Hey, Brent.
Did you know that some of your commercials don't show up, don't sound on the radio?
Oh, really?
El Cazador's and Happy Tales, you can't hear them.
Huh. Wonder how come, I just wonder.
I don't know.
Well, we'll see if we can't work on that.
I noticed last week that it's doing that, too.
What's it sound like, Red? Nothing? Just
you can barely hear it on the radio.
Yeah, I'm going to have to get...
come back on, and you're loud.
Yeah, well, we're going to have to pull that up loud. Next time, run the CD up loud and see if it goes across.
Yeah, we'll put it up a little louder than what we do with the board, see if it does any better. You can call and let us know.
Okay, I just thought I'd let y'all know.
Thank you, Red.
Thanks, Red.
Bye.
Yeah, we've got Frank Kimmel. It's all Venturini Motorsports show tonight and next week. But we got Frank Kimmel, the mastermind, the man behind it all at 7:30. He is the one of the coaches for them when he's not driving. He coaches those guys, too. At 8 o'clock is Brandon Jones, a good little racer, man. He's going to be good. He's already good, and he's doing... I'll give you a little bit about Brandon Jones here. In 9 career ARCA starts, Jones has yet to finish outside the top 10. His impressive stat sheets include back-to-back wins in 2013 to go along with the 6 top fives and 8 top tens finishing over the last two seasons. He also is driving for 4 different teams. ARCA is Venturini Motorsports. NASCAR Infinity is driving for Richard Childress Racing. NASCAR Camping World, he's driving for GMS Racing. And the K&N Pro Series East, NTS Motorsports. He's racing in a bunch of divisions. Brandon Jones is young. So look out. He's going to be another good one for them. Yep. Also, oh, you had a phone call?
They hung up.
Frank Kimball. He's got 10 ARCA championships, Big G, from 1998 to 2013. Finishes in the top 10, 23 consecutive seasons. Frank is also all-time leader with 80 victories. His win column includes victories at Atlanta, Berlin, Chicago, DeQuino, Elko, Five Flags, Flat Rock, Flemington, Gateway, Iowa, Kansas, Kentucky, Kilcare, Lake Erie, Lowe's, Lucas Oil Raceway, MIS, which is Michigan, Milwaukee, Nashville, Pocono, Salem. It goes on and on. South Boston, Talladega, Winchester. His brother Bill Kimball is an 8-time crew chief of the year. Father Bill Kimball Sr. is a 3-time ARCA winner. Frank's son, Frank II, also competes in the ARCA Tour. Man, what stats on him. And then at 8:30, we're going to have Cody Coughlin. He's a Joe Gibbs development driver, and he's going to be he drives the number 55 for Venturini. 6 starts, 2 top fives, 3 top tens, finished 4th at Daytona, season's best 2nd place at Talladega, won the pole at Talladega and Chicago. Cody Coughlin, the 2013 JEGS CRA All-Star Tour champion, made his ARCA Racing Series in 2014, driving the number 55 JEGS Toyota for Venturini Motorsports. A development driver under the Joe Gibbs Racing banner, Cody finished a career best 2nd at Talladega in 2015. Led 11 laps after finishing a previous career 4th at Daytona International Speedway in 2015. He also earned a Menards pole presented by Ansel at Talladega. He also finished 4th at Kentucky in 2014, 4th at Kansas in 2014. In 15 ARCA starts overall, he earned 10 top 10 finishes, including 5th at Chicagoland, 6th at New Jersey Road Course, 6th at Toledo, 7th at Winchester, 9th at Salem, 9th at Pocono. Cody's career best ARCA qualifying run is 2nd at Daytona in 2015, 5th in Chicago in 2014, also 6th at Pocono in Michigan and Kentucky. Another good driver. No wonder. I mean, Venturini can pull him out of the stable, man. Do you know what?
Yeah, he's got a good.
So tonight's show is going to be very exciting, and I can't wait to get it going here good. And Big G, what did you think about the wreck, you and Bullet, of the wreck at Daytona with Austin Dillon walking out of that car, which was just a piece of a shell?
He's lucky. Well, I ain't going to say he's lucky. He's fortunate to be walking.
Good Lord was looking over him on that. I can tell you that.
Sure was.
Uncle D's not with us tonight. So he's a scratch. He's got computer problems. Uncle D will be racing, I think, Friday night at Full Throttle Speedway himself. His first debut is racing a truck, number 1 truck. Is what it is. Like a turquoise color, beautiful truck. I've done seen a picture of it. He's going to be racing out there. Can you believe it? At 60, I think he is it Uncle D 67, I think.
I think so. Something like it.
He's going to be racing.
He still don't have Morgan beat.
Huh?
He still don't have Morgan beat.
Yeah.
Morgan be 170 before he quits.
You got that right. But
I shouldn't have said that.
You know, I was talking about that wreck. There was 13 fans got hurt.
Yes. Look at there, Big G. There's a picture of the truck, of a rear end of it, that what's-his-face will be driving, Uncle D.
Okay.
And you'll be driving ovarian cancer is for the teal. It's a teal color. But Uncle D will try to see what he can do on the track. I'm sure it'll be well worth watching. And we want to see him back next week with the Whoop on Wheels show.
Yes, we do.
Because we need him back here.
Need him back.
And he will be back. It's just, here's a picture of the truck.
That's a pretty truck.
Beautiful truck there of Uncle D's. Be driving the number one teal for ovarian cancer sponsor.
And that's
Project Track Champion sponsor.
That's why it's painted the color it's painted.
It makes sense. It does make sense.
That's the reason it's painted that color.
But Austin went over two sets of rows when he got caught in the catch fence about 185-90 mile an hour, and it stopped the car. Took the engine out, set it on fire.
Since you seen it, did he get bumped or...
He didn't get what happened was looked like Denny Hamlin got clipped or clipped somebody. I don't know how it happened, and it was a chain reaction thing. I was at 3 o'clock in the morning when this happened, so I was very tired.
Yeah,
I'd been asleep for about 3 hours and woke up, wanted to see who won it, and they had 10 laps left. Junior led about 90 something of the laps. He won the race, of course.
JR won. All right.
And we do have a new backdrop up here with JR.
We do, and it is nice.
And it is nice.
Red, white,
and
blue.
And I will go over the point standings here, Big G, of last week. Right now, the top 16 in the Sprint Cup is Kevin Harvick's leading this thing with 656 points. Guess who's second? Dale Earnhardt Jr. with 593. Two wins.
Wasn't he like in fourth last week or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, or fifth, sixth. Fifth? I don't know. That win just fifth. Boosted him.
He was in fifth. That's right.
Jimmy Johnson's third. Joey Logano is in fourth. Martin Truex Jr. fifth. Jamie McMurray is sixth. Brad Keselowski seventh. Kurt Busch is eighth. Matt Kenseth's ninth. Jeff Gordon's tenth. Casey Kane's 11th. Denny Hamlin's 12th. Paul Menard 13th, Ryan Newman 14th, Clint Bowyer 15th, Eric Almirola rounds out the top 16 with 441 points. That is how it done. And then Dale Earnhardt Jr. won it. Jimmy Johnson was second. Denny Hamlin third, Kevin Harvick fourth, Kurt Busch come in fifth, Jeff Gordon was sixth, Austin Dillon was a piece of a car come in seventh, Ryan Newman eighth, Trevor Bayne ninth. This all happened at the flag stand, Gerald.
On the last lap?
Yeah.
I was wondering how you come in seventh. Yep.
Clint Bowyer, 10th. Casey Kane was 11th. David Reagan in the number 55 was 12th. Landon Castle, good run for him, 13th. Tony Stewart, 14th. Jamie McMurray, 15th. And Paul Menard, 16th. Kyle Busch. Kyle had a disappointing 17th place. He needs to be 14th or above to get to the top 30 in points.
He still got how many spots? Where would you say he was at in points?
Well, it only gives me the top
16.
That's all they're worried about.
I think he was 35th last week when we looked.
And well, he won and moved him up to 36th.
Well, 36th. Then he dropped back 17th this year, week.
Xfinity is Austin Dillon won it. I bet he didn't even have a clue that he's going to be in the catch fence on this other one. Elliott Sadler, second. Chase Elliott come in third. Casey Kane, fourth in the number 88 car of Dale Earnhardt Jr.'s. Benny Gordon. Benny Gordon had a good run of 66 in the Xfinity. Come in fifth. Dakota Armstrong was sixth. David Reagan was seventh. Eric Jones, eighth. Harrison Rhodes, ninth. Ross Chastain, tenth. Our good buddy, Timmy Hill, come in 11th in the Xfinity series. Chris Bouchard, 12th. Ryan Reed, 13th. Joey Logano was 14th. Daniel Suarez was 15th. Peyton Sellers, 16th. That's the top 16. Xfinity, Morgan Shepherd, 39th. He had an overheating problem. Out of 40 cars. Chris Bouchard leads it in the points. Chase Elliott, second. Ty Dillon is third. Reagan Smith, fourth. Elliott Sadler's fifth. Darrell Wallace Jr., sixth. Brian Scott, seventh. And eighth is Ryan Reed. Brendan Gaughan is ninth. And Daniel Suarez is tenth. That's your top ten.
How many points Elliott behind?
Elliott who? Sadler?
No. Elliott. Chase.
Bouchard has 560 and Chase Elliott has 526.
Oh.
What?
Quite a bit behind him.
30-something points.
Yeah, about 32, 31,
that ain't bad.
32.
He can get it. He can do it.
Yeah. He was in third there for a little while.
Let's take another break here, Big G. Get me queued up here. I'm going to play you one here.
How about it?
Get you hot and ready.
Thank you.
I love hot dogs and I love pizza. But Pizza Hut's new Hot Dog Bites pizza? You went too far, Pizza Hut. Who puts 28 hot dog bites baked into the crust around a perfectly good pizza? Oh, so I get to eat pizza and also dip hot dog bites in the mustard sauce? You kidding me? I mean, it's just... Okay, that sounds awesome. You got me, Pizza Hut.
The new Hot Dog Bites pizza. Two tasty classics in one ridiculously delicious mashup. For a limited time, get a large one-topping Hot Dog Bites pizza for just $11.99. Only at Pizza Hut.
Limited time offer. Only available in original and pretzel crust flavors.
This is the sound that a mountain of biscuit dough makes when a rolling pin rolls it into flat, doughy planes. And if you listen really closely, you can hear the light sprinkling of flour onto biscuit dough. Hear that? That's a dough cutter carving out the circles that will rise into biscuits. This is made from scratch.
The Grilled Pork Chop Biscuit with fluffy egg and melting American cheese. Only at Hardee's. For a limited time at participating restaurants.
Our biscuits aren't made from scratch, like that cabinet you still haven't assembled, because the instruction manual is written in a code you need to be a member of the Swedish Embassy to crack. No, our biscuits are made from scratch, like biscuit bakers wake up at the crack of dawn every morning to transform buttermilk and flour into a perfect golden brown mound of hot buttered biscuit. The made from scratch country fried steak and gravy biscuit, smothered in sausage gravy, only at Hardee's. For a limited time, participating restaurants.
Hey, hon. What you up to?
Oh, just looking online for something to do with the kids this weekend.
Well, I heard the weather's going to be great. Let's get outside and do something fun.
That sounds perfect. What'd you have in mind?
We make memories every day. Why not make ones that matter? Come to the place where adventure runs wild, laughter is contagious, and the smiles are endless. Your ticket to fun is waiting for you and the whole family at Lake Winnie Amusement Park. For 90 years, families have created unforgettable memories at one of Chattanooga's best-kept secrets.
Wow, what a day. Are you ready to head home?
Well, can we ride the roller coaster one more time? I mean, I'm sure the kids would want to.
Of course. We wouldn't want to upset the kids now, would we?
Now open 7 days a week. One grandparent age 55 or older receives a free admission with one child admission under age 18. For more information, visit lakewinnie.com. Let's make memories that matter.
Hey, hon. What you up to?
Oh, just looking online for something to do with the kids this weekend.
Well, I heard the weather's going to be great. Let's get outside and do something fun.
That sounds perfect. What'd you have in mind?
We make memories every day. Why not make ones that matter? Come to the place where adventure runs wild, laughter is contagious, and the smiles are endless. Your ticket to fun is waiting for you and the whole family at Lake Winnie Amusement Park. For 90 years, families have created unforgettable memories at one of Chattanooga's best-kept secrets.
Wow, what a day. Are you ready to head home?
Well, can we ride the roller coaster one more time? I mean, I'm sure the kids would want to.
Of course. We wouldn't want to upset the kids now, would we?
Now open 7 days a week. On Thursdays, bring a canned food item and save $5 on an unlimited ride pass. For more information, visit lakewinnie.com. Let's make memories that matter.
Hey, hon.
When the Whoop on Wheels crew gets back from a long weekend spent in the infield in Talladega, their first stop in town is Surf's Up Car Wash. Surf's Up, 2575 Guthrie Street Northwest, located next to Cleveland Utilities, 790-5793. Surf's Up Car Wash, voted Cleveland's best 3 years in a row. Stop by and see Mike Royville and his gang at Surf's Up. Whoop on Wheels is proud to be sponsored by Emmanuel and the Gondolier. If you're in the Ottawa area, stop in and see us at Emmanuel's. Phone number 910-0459. Emmanuel's, for all your Italian and Greek specialties, as well as the best pizza in town. Gondolier locations are at Okoy, 1603 Highway 64, Benton, Tennessee. That phone number, 338-7299. Stop in and see the fine folks at the Okoy Gondolier. And if you're in the Cleveland area, they're located at 3300 Keith Street, 472-4998. All items at Emmanuel and the Gondolier can be fixed for you to take home. Proud sponsors of Whoop on Wheels, Emmanuel and the Gondolier. When Big G and Fast Eddie need to make a pit stop for lunch, they head to Quiznos. Stop in and see Roger Patel and his crew at Quiznos Sub, 2151 Keith Street. Phone number 473-7976. For all your box lunches and catering needs, stop in and see the folks at Quiznos Sub. Quiznos. Toasty. El Cazador Mexican Restaurant, located at 2299 Keith Street. Phone number 790-0563. Lunch and happy hour specials daily. Stop in to the El Cazador Mexican Restaurant and try some of our new dishes, as well as our large vegetarian menu. El Cazador, for my money, the best Mexican restaurant in town. For all your pet grooming needs, see the staff at Happy Tails Grooming Salon. Happy Tails, located at 2251 North Okoy Street. Business hours are Tuesday through Friday, 8 to 5:30, Saturday, 9 to 5:30. For your appointment, call 339-5777. A full-service professional groomer. Happy Tails Grooming Salon. Come shaggy, leave happy.
Don't know what happened there. Dadgummit. Anyway, we got some more commercials here we got to go with, and Fast Eddie's going to have to get a hold of Morgan on the phone. So
you're going to have to give me the phone number.
I got your phone number. Oh, I got to give you a number, don't I? Anyway, the 45th anniversary for the Singing Echoes. They're coming to town next. They're coming to town July the 15th through the 18th. They're bringing their good friends with them. Mallory Lefford's going to be there, Tuba Two Quartet, Meadow Lane, Wednesday, July the 15th. Thursday, July the 16th. They're going to be the Singing Echoes. They're going to be there every night through the 15th through the 18th. So go ahead and plan on coming to seeing them every night. They're a great, great, great bluegrass type quartet. They do the bluegrass and also the other. The one that I think I want to see, I want to see the Inspirations. And also too, I want to see Archie Watkins too. He'll be there Saturday, July the 18th. Primrose Quartet, Archie Watkins, Smoky Mountain Reunion, Tim Frith, and Gospel Echo Song Quartet, and Sheila Reed. You say that and don't that number don't work? It should work. That's one I always call. So, anyway, go and see the Singing Echoes 45th anniversary. 45 years they've been doing this, and that's a long, long time for them to be doing that. So, we got Heads Up Hair Design, Carmen Wilson. Go see Carmen. Call and make an appointment to get your hair cut with her. Her phone number is 476-5722. 60 Mouse Creek Road is where she's at. Walk-ins is welcome if they're not busy. So, L&B Appliances, go by and see the guys over at L&B Appliances. They got great prices on top brands, appliances. They can furnish your whole home. It's family-owned and operated. They're good people deal with over there. L&B Sales, they carry a large selection of appliances, home furnishings, a refrigerator, cooktop stoves, ovens, ranges, washer, dryers. They carry anything you want to cook with, dishwashers and all that kind of good stuff. At L&B, they're at 160 Mouse Creek Road, Northeast, here in Cleveland, 423-339-3231. That's the number. Call over there, and they've got all kinds of good appliances, all brand name appliances they got. So anyway, that is L&B appliance sales, and they're a bunch of good folks over there. Go over there and be with them. And I think he's got Morgan on the phone now. So. We're going to put Morgan on the line right now. Let's see if I can do this without hanging him up there. If I hang him up, he'll probably shoot me. How about Morgan?
What you doing?
I'm trying to operate all these buttons over here. How am I doing?
You're doing good.
Okay.
Well, Fast Eddie's got a hard job, ain't he?
Yeah.
Big G's finding out the hard way.
Well, it's all right when you do it every day, but if you don't do it every day, it's kind of hard.
You got that right.
That's my first time in 4 months.
Well, you're doing all right.
All right, then. Well, how's Morgan doing?
Good. We just finished up having us a little seafood here at Captain's Gallery.
All right. Where's that at? In North Carolina?
It's Hickory.
In Hickory?
Yeah, just a few miles from our house.
Boy, Morgan, I'll tell you what, your car looked good in Daytona.
Well, if it hadn't been for our friend Tony Furr coming up, helping Claude and I, we wouldn't even got to make that one lap. We got on the track with about 4 minutes to go. And what was it? Cindy said 2 minutes to go. And made one lap. And so... then we had to start getting ready for qualifying. And so that was our second lap on the racetrack. And there was some of the guys over there, they was talking about who was going to get in and who wasn't. And Derek Cope and them said, well, Morgan won't make it. And some of the other guys said that they didn't think we would get in. And Tony Furr told them, says, guys, he's got a fast car.
That's right.
And anyway, we qualified 29th. If we would have had a little time on the track to adjust a few things, the car would have been on up, I know, at least in the top 15.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because I said, my goodness, he qualified up there good. And I was watching the board, and I said, you know, four of them was going to have to go home. I said, Morgan ain't going to be going home. He's in this thing. He's got it sewed up.
Yeah, I went over to congratulate Austin and Mike Dillon and Richard and all of them when Austin won the race. And I went over and old Richard, he says, how about that motor? And I said, that motor's good.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're happy that somebody's taking care of that deal for us, and we're blessed to have some horsepower now, so maybe we can show some things, different tracks we'll go to.
I think they said on the air that Tony Furr was working with you too, and
yeah, he was with Derek Cope down there, but he helped me get the car ready to go, and if he hadn't come up and done it, that's no way, because just me and Claude.
Yeah.
We've got another guy that has come by to help us now. He's inexperienced, but we just need some helping hands, you know.
Yeah, that's right. If you had helping hands and some more money, no telling what'd happen, Morgan, because that car is beautiful. It looked good.
Yes. We're going to get it ready to go to Indy. We had a conference call yesterday with NASCAR. And they was talking about different things for Indy and the gear ratios and stuff. And so what they've decided to do is let the Daytona-type cars run. But we've got to add another inch to the rear bumper, and they're going to have a new spoiler. What they'll do is use the regular spoiler, and then they're going to have a polycarbon clear piece that we bolt on, so they're putting more downforce in the car to try to slow them down a little bit. But it'll make better racing because they'll go through the corners fast.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, I was pleased the way it was going. It says on these spec sheets that Morgan was overheating.
Yeah, what happened was somebody's tear-off come off, and guess whose grill it landed on?
Oh, no.
Yeah, the temperature started going up, so I for sure had to take care of the engine. And
yeah, you wanted to take care of that engine. I don't blame you. I mean, yeah. Good night. And you done the right thing.
Yeah, we I don't want to run a good motor, especially we just got one. This is great having something that'll run.
Yeah, but I mean, just looking at the outside of the car, it looks so good. I mean, you know, that cross and everything looks good on it. I like the colors. It was good. And they said something on there, this is one of Morgan's old paint schemes.
Yeah.
What they said on TV.
Yeah, this is our Black Thunder.
Yeah, that's what they said. I couldn't remember, but I did hear them say Thunder.
Yeah, yeah. This car was the one that I ran in 87, 88 in that area. I think I ran it like 5 years, and that thing won everywhere we went.
Well, I'm going to tell you something, Morgan. I like them announcers, Rick Allen and Jeff Burton and Steve Letarte.
Well, they can't be nothing but good because, you know, they've got all this experience. They can explain anything that's going on, whether it's the mechanical side or whatever happens with the race cars. They got a inside seat. I mean, you know, Jeff's had all the years of driving, and so he can tell that. And then the other guys talk about the setups or whatever, you know, what the cars are doing. They know all the facts. They know, you know, how to tell everybody what's going on with the race car.
Exactly.
So that makes them good announcers.
And Steve Letarte, being a crew chief for Junior, I mean, you know, he knows that stuff good.
Yeah. Yeah.
What about Austin?
Started out as a sweeper, floor sweeper there.
I know it. What about Austin's wreck? That catch fence, I think it done its job. Don't you say, yeah. Think?
Well, you know, I didn't know nothing about the wreck. We drove back from Daytona, got home late, and so the race ended up being after 11 o'clock. And so I ended up going to sleep. So I didn't see one lap of the race. I didn't hear anything about the wreck until the next day, about, I don't know, 4:30 or 5, my wife said, said that Austin had wrecked, and so she showed me the video on the telephone, and my goodness, and so we text Mike Dillon, his dad, and said, God is good.
Yeah.
You know, Austin and Ty is Christians, and Mike is, and they've really got Grandpa going too.
Yeah, and when I seen that, and when that happened, Junior's, you know, his crew was down at the very first stall. They run out there, and they didn't get penalized for that because they wanted them to get Austin out of that car.
Yeah.
You know, he didn't, I mean, well, that shell, it wasn't nothing but a shell. It took that engine, set it down on the ground, and it was on fire. The engine was. It was unbelievable.
I know. I've seen the video of it.
I just couldn't believe it. They're going to. I don't know. I believe they're going to slow them down more. Don't you, Morgan? Slow them cars down some more or something.
Yeah, they'll continue to work on things. And anyway, you know, when Carl Edwards spun out there, you know, nobody was right on him or anything. It just car went out of control. So they need for these cars to handle as good as they can to try to stop some of that stuff. And to tell you the truth, I've seen it on, Cindy showed it to me on the phone. I haven't really got a good view other than, I mean, that thing just going up in the catch fence and coming all apart.
Oh, yeah. It was something else, I'm telling you.
I've been busy here working with the race car trying to get it ready. It's got to be up there at 6 o'clock tomorrow. And I've just arrived back at the house and
okay.
Getting ready to go to the garage.
Well, Morgan, it's a pleasure getting to talk with you. You know, you told me you wouldn't have it about 10 minutes tonight. And when's your next race? Are you going to race at Iowa?
Friday night. Friday night at Kentucky.
Oh. All right. That'll be a good one, too, Morgan.
Yeah, I'm looking forward. The track is real bumpy up there, so handling really comes into play. And so I'm real excited about how we've gotten our car going and with this new engine in it. I'm double tickled.
Is Tony going to come up and help you?
No. He just he's came up and helped me. He came in about lunch today, and he helped me yesterday.
Yeah.
So we still got some work to do. I see Claude out here on the ground putting new batteries in the truck, or one of the guys that was helping us down at Daytona, he left the switch on the back tailgate, and it killed the batteries, so they wouldn't even take a charge back, so we had to go
get
new batteries for it. So Claude's out here sitting on a steel milk crate, getting ready to put these batteries in the car.
Boy, oh boy. Well, Morgan, we'll let you go then, and it was good talking with you, and we'll holler at you next Tuesday night. How's that?
That'd be great. And
guess who's following you tonight?
Thanks to all the race fans that helped make this possible, and God bless the Mike Dillon family that Austin just walked away with a few bruises and stuff.
That's right. Frank Kimball comes on next. All Venturini Motorsports guys.
Yeah, I've known Frank for a long time, many, many years.
Yeah, Frank and Brandon Jones and Cody Coughlin.
You got a good cast tonight.
Oh, yeah, Venturini set me up good tonight, and they got next week's show also. So I don't know what they'll send me next week, but this week's dynamite. But we'll be calling you next Tuesday night.
Okay.
Good luck at Kentucky.
Thank you.
All right.
All right. Talk to you later, Morgan.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Morgan Shepherd.
Yep. I was trying to bring that video up. I believe NASCAR's had YouTube take it off.
Probably. Let's take another break. Big G, come back.
All right.
Kick your air control, air one, and pull the BSI down. Yeah.
All right, we're back. And
Big G's had a health break. He's back with us now.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Anyway, we got trying to find my notebook now, Fast Eddie. I'm about like you. I lost my notebook.
You want to talk about these three guys again, and I'll be right back.
You know, yeah, Frank Kimble.
You got Frank next. You got Brandon Jones, and then Cody Coughlin.
Cody Coughlin, yep. Frank Kimble. He's if you want to say, he's probably a legend in ARCA. Man can drive a car. I love to watch Frank Kimble drive on. He's 10-time ARCA champion, 80 career ARCA wins, 26 season in ARCA, co-driver of the number 25 on sale Menard Toyota on sale. That's a weird word for me, on sale. Made the move to the Vetturini Motorsports during the offseason, drives 10 of 20 ARCA races, splitting driver duties with Brandon Jones, acting as team driver, coach, weekend. He's not driving, also spotting for Brandon. In 2015 season stats, 6 starts, 3 top 5s, and 3 top 10s. Finished 5th at Daytona, finished season high 2nd at Michigan. And the next ARCA race is Pocono, August the 1st. All right, Brandon Jones, he's Richard Childress development driver, co-owner of the number 25 on sale Menard Toyota, made the move of Vetturini Motorsports during the off season. He's driving, driving NASCAR Camping World truck race on Thursday with GMS Racing. Next ARCA race is Iowa on July the 17th. So that's coming up this week, next weekend. 2015 ARCA season stats is 6 starts, 4 top 10 ARCA fives. Stats is 6 starts, 4 top 10 ARCA fives. Stats is 6 what are starts, you doing? 4 top 10 ARCA
fives.
Stats is 6 what starts. I don't know what he's doing. He's over here goofing off. I'm going to cut him off here in a minute. I got power to cut him off. Finished the season high 2nd at Mobile International Speedway. Finished 3rd last week at Winchester after leading 98 of 2,000 laps. ARCA career stats, 17 races, 7 top 5s, and 14 top 10s. That's Brandon Jones. Cody Coughlin, a Joe Gibbs development racer, race car driver, driver of the number 55 GEGS Toyota in the ARCA series, joined Vetturini Motorsports in 2014, making his NASCAR Camping World Truck Series debut Thursday at Kentucky, driving Vetturini number 25 GEGS Toyota Tundra. 2015 ARCA stats is 6 starts, 2 top 10, 2 top 5s, and a 3rd top 10. And also, he won the pole at Talladega and Chicago. Season best, second place finish at Talladega.
Let's take another break. We'll be back. Here we go.
Make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place. Singing, we will rock you. We will rock you. Buddy, you're a young man, hard man, shouting in the street. Gonna take on the world someday. You got blood on your face. A big disgrace, waving your banner all over the place.
got enough of Bee Gees right there.
Yep, we're back.
The Bee Gees.
You know what? They was a great group back in their days.
Oh, yeah.
I always liked them.
They were. They were great.
Great, great, great bunch there.
And we are... that's not him.
That's not our call that we was looking for.
No, we were looking for Frank Kimmel.
Yep.
He's supposed Frank. To be calling in here at 7:30. So I hope he didn't forget to call us.
I do, too. We'll just have to play music, talk, take phone call, whatever.
All right, let's play another song here. I've got another one queued up on the charts here.
All right, go ahead.
It's the throne everyone wants. Some will use strength.
Back to Whoop on Wheels, ain't we, Big G? 99.9 FM and WhoopFM.com on your listening dial. And we haven't heard from Frank Kimball yet.
Yeah, we're back.
Okay, Tom is calling him right now.
Okay.
That's a good thing.
That's a good thing. Right
there. That's the good thing.
Yeah. Putting the pot up on the dot. Make sure we got it on the dot. Yeah, I've seen that Rick Air Fest. It wasn't pretty, was it?
It was not pretty at all.
And I am so glad that he walked away.
Now, Big G, before we go any farther, I'm going to talk about L&B Appliances at 339-3231. That is Josh Taylor over there. They're family-owned and operated. They're large enough to meet all your home's appliance needs and small enough to appreciate your business. And they got all the appliances, brand names, Amana, Electrolux, Frigidaire, Maytag, and Whirlpool. And great prices on all of these top brands. And they have refrigerators, cooktops, stoves, and ovens, ranges, washer and dryers. Go by and see old Josh at 160 Durkee Road, Northeast Cleveland, Tennessee. 339-3231. Heads up Hair Design, Carmen Wilson. Couldn't say enough about Carmen.
Great
she
person.
And using number four on Big G and make him look like he's come out of the cow pasture right into the world here.
If I didn't use a four, I wouldn't have no hair.
That's true.
Look at.
And Carmen's there about every day of the week, so go by and see her at 476-5722, 60 Mouse Creek Road.
Look at that.
Call and get you an appointment there. Roger Turpin, Perkett's Yogurt. Man, some of the best yogurt around. You got the diabetic yogurt that Big G gets all the time over there. He loves that no-sugar yogurt.
Yep. And tell no difference, man.
I'm the vanilla man. I like vanilla. Out of 52 flavors, I'll go with vanilla.
They probably more flavors than that, you know it.
Yeah, but Roger Turpin, 3306 Key Street. Go by and see him at Perkett's, 476-1668. For all your good, they got it in the cone cups. Start out with a kitty cup, and they go right up. All right.
Got the phone call here, Fast Eddie.
All right.
Caller, go ahead. You live on Whoop.
Hello, this is Frank Kimmel.
Hey, Frank. How you doing?
Good, man.
How you doing?
I'm doing real good. Driving down the highway in a thunderstorm, so I hope I don't lose you.
Yeah, I hope not either, but this is the Arca Tech Man here. This is the mastermind of Arca. Frank is one of the best in my book.
He is. He's one of the best. Or
he is the best. I shouldn't say one of the best.
He's the best.
Yes.
You guys got some low standards.
No, we're hoping you build ours up.
Well, you're with a good group now, ain't you, Frank?
Yeah, it's been a really good year so far. We run well. The cars have been fast. We recently, I thought, got a really good finish at Michigan and ran well at Chicago. And I think it's been a good season so far. I wish we could do it all with them, and I think we'd even be stronger. But thanks for going well.
Yeah, and over there at Venturini, you couldn't ask for nobody better than old Tom over there, Tommy and Bill. Just a great bunch of people at Venturini Motorsports. I pull for them in ARCA. All you guys that's in ARCA, Venturinis, I pull for you.
Yeah, they've been really good to me. I mean, you know, we've been competitors for a long time and ran against each other for a long time. So it's been a good relationship so far, and I think it's just going to get better and better.
Yeah, I know they're glad to have you. And you're splitting time with Brandon Jones, I think, on that 25, ain't you?
Yeah, we got a deal today that we, this year that we do 10 races, and Brandon gets to do 10, and we actually picked up an extra race for Talladega, so I'm actually going to do 11 this year. But Brandon is a really nice young man, and his family has been great to work with. When he's racing, I spot for him, and that's worked out really well also.
Oh yeah. Now who spots for you, Frank, when you're doing it?
They have a gentleman by the name of Britt spots for me at Talladega. My son did it. At Daytona, we actually had another guy do it. So It's been a hodgepodge of people that's done it. And
is your son's name Will?
No, that's my nephew.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And Bill's your brother.
Bill's my brother, and my son's name's Frankie.
Oh, okay. I got you.
Yeah, that way it was easier to remember.
Yeah, that is. Right, Big G?
That's it. That'd be the way that I'd have to do it.
You got to do it that way. Now, where are you heading to right now as we speak?
I was in Charlotte this weekend. I drove down me and my wife drove down to see my kids, Frankie and Holly, both live in Charlotte. They graduated college down there, and they're doing really well. And so we just came down for the 4th and hung out with them for a couple of days, and now we're headed home. We're in Danville, Kentucky right now.
Well, now, Frank, I've had you on the show before, but it was when you was on your own and not with Venturini. But I got to ask you this question. What made you never want, or you never did come out of ARCA? You stayed in ARCA all these years.
Well, we actually did run like 6 or 7 or 8 cup races back in the day. And then we run, I think, only one nationwide race, maybe 2, and then a few truck races. But you know, I had my major sponsor for many, many years was Advance Auto Parts, and they were a great company to deal with. And, they had the budget to run ARCA, and they just didn't feel like moving up was in their best interest. And, we were located, most of our races was right in their wheelhouse, right where they were located. So they felt like they liked the ARCA races and what we had to offer for that amount of money. And, as we all know, there every step you make up, you got to start adding zeros to your check, and we just didn't have the money to do it. And I would have loved to got to run a whole year in NASCAR and do all the testing and the stuff that those guys do to do so well. Mm-hmm. We just never had that opportunity. So I was very fortunate that I still got to race in ARCA and made a living doing it. So I feel like I'm a pretty lucky guy.
You are, Frank. You are, and from what I understand, there's a lot of people comes to you for advice in the ARCA.
Yeah, we have over the years, there's been a lot of kids that come in and actually older guys too that come in and they have questions about the racetracks or whatever, where we're going. And I try to help as much as I can. Most of these young guys that come in racing now, they've got it pretty figured out. They don't really need my help. But it's nice that they still come and ask sometimes, and we've had some good relationships over the years.
Well, that's good to have good relationships. And, I've watched you run for years, and, there's really nobody that, I've seen out there run that is good as you are.
Well, I appreciate that, but there's been a lot of really good ones out there. Maybe I've just been here longer.
Well, no, you just kicking a rear end is what you're doing.
We've had some great luck for sure.
But now you've had some good cars, and only the marker cars, they're a lot slower than
not really on some of it, is it, Frank?
No, they actually restrict our motors down, just like they do the cup cars now. And there's places that we run as fast as they do. The biggest thing is the competition level and those guys. And now that the cars are so different, and like I say, we're running restrictor plates on all the big tracks now. And so they keep us calmed down. But when we were running open, there was times that we would go to racetracks and we would qualify pretty close to what they would qualify. The big thing is they've got 35 cars that are all within a second, and we might have 8 or 10, so it's just the competition level is quite a bit better over there.
Yeah, that's about what I was going to ask you there. I know once, you kind of sit and listen to them, when they was running the all different kind of cars. I've heard them talk, you all might be 80 horsepower lower than, the cup cars, or some of them, could be as much as 100 horsepower less. But like you said, y'all kind of got built up where you're about the same, then they restrict you back down. looked like they kind of left it alone, just let you run what you already had, wouldn't it?
Well, there's pros and cons to it. You know, I think that it's probably, as we've seen this weekend, I think racing at 200 mile an hour is probably pretty stupid.
Yeah.
I've never thought, you know, really fast cars don't make for really good races. There's been a lot of divisions that's proved that over the years, and so I think they'll probably end up slowing us down some more. And you know, as far as we were actually leasing motors from the Cup guys. You know, I was using Yates motors when I had a Ford, and you know, we would get motors just from Doug Yates, just like all the other Ford guys were doing. So
yeah,
you know, get the power. It's a lot more. You know, there's a lot more to it than just having horsepower. You got to get through the turn, and you know, we're on Hoosier tires, and they're on Goodyears, and their aero package is quite a bit different than what we have. And you know, I think as long as everybody's got to deal with the same set of circumstances, it doesn't matter if you race at 200 mile an hour or at 160 mile an hour. The fans really won't be able to tell the difference, and other than the fact there'll be a lot better racing when you slow us down.
Yeah, yeah. I think you're right about that, Frank.
Just, yeah,
without a doubt.
Because at them high speeds, I mean, Austin's a lucky man right there when he went into that catch fence. You know, I mean, thank goodness the catch fence kept that car out of the stands.
Well, you know, like I told somebody today, I was talking about it when I was in Charlotte, and you know, there people are complaining about NASCAR being safe and all that, but it did exactly what it's designed to do.
Yes.
It slowed the car. It didn't kill the driver. It pushed him back out onto the racetrack, which is where he belongs. I don't know what else they want. I mean, yeah, there's debris that gets up in the stands, and, you know, that's a really scary situation. But, you know, I said all along that whoever told everybody that racing is going to be safe is lying. It's not. I mean, this is what we do, and, you know, if you think you can take a race car and you can run 200 mile an hour side to side with somebody, and then you go three wide and you go four or five or 10 or 15 rows deep, it's not going to be good if somebody messes up or something breaks or something happens. And, you know, and that's the animal that we have to deal with right now with the Cup cars. But, you know, as far as their safety, what else could anybody ask for? It did really, really well. I mean, the car, it saved Austin. He walked away from it, and nobody in the stands got hit severely injured. The fence held up like it's supposed to. I thought it was a really good deal for NASCAR across the board. It did exactly what they designed it to do.
Well, you know, I applaud NASCAR. I don't have much bad to say about what NASCAR does. I mean, you know, they're out there to save lives. They're not out there to kill people, and you know, we all know that. But you know, if I'm not mistaken, that's the same track at Bodine. He went into the catch fence about same spot, if I'm not mistaken, and then they put that fence a little bit further over the racetrack to keep that from happening, you know, the car going up in the stands.
Yeah, I think the big thing they did, they actually moved the grandstands away from the fence.
Yeah, they did that, and I remember too, or something, they said they was going to make it in a more of an angle to stand out over the track more, or try to keep the parts and pieces inside the track, not let it go in the stands. But like you said, you know, that stuff's going to happen. Little pieces of sheet metal and stuff like that, it's going to get through that fence.
Yeah, it's going to be really difficult to stop that, that's for sure.
Now, Frank, on some of your other tracks that you run, do they have catch fences? You know, like Winchester?
Oh, yeah. Everywhere we go has a catch fence in front of the main grandstands for sure. We have a couple racetracks that actually don't have a wall at all. Once you get past turn one and all the way down to backstretch, there's no wall at all, but there's enough runoff area that you know, people are okay if they do get off the racetrack. So it's but there's no people or no stands or nobody watching the race from that angle, so it's not a problem. And
yeah.
But, you know, everywhere we go, I mean, ARCA is, you know, they've been pretty big on the safety thing, just like NASCAR.
And the safer barrier walls, too?
most of our tracks that we run, of course, all the conjunction tracks that we run have safer barriers, and so the short tracks don't. But our speeds aren't near, you know, near what you have when you go to a mile and a half.
Yeah.
You know, that's we was talking about the safety barrier. You know, they made that one wall safety barrier Fast Eddie at Talladega.
Yeah.
That Kyle hit.
No, that was that Daytona?
That's Daytona. He hit, yeah, because he didn't make the first several races because he had that broke foot. Then now we end up with the catch fence deal. So then I think they had a few. I did see some of the race. I seen where they had a couple of wrecks where they went in and I heard Kyle mention his comments that they shouldn't have grass nowhere, you know, especially on the front stretch, no grass at all. But I seen two were that a couple of wrecks where if they didn't have the grass, they would have kept sliding into the wall or whatever. And I heard one of them say, you know, one of the announcers make comments, said, "Who says we don't need grass now?" You know, kind of making a joke about it, you know.
Yeah, I mean, I really don't. The grass is pretty, but really it should be gone. I do agree with that. And here's the reason. If it rains, you know, dry grass is one thing to drive into. Wet grass is a whole other animal.
Oh, I bet so.
Correct.
So if you're going to, at those high-speed places like that, and, you know, they should have safer barriers all the way around the racetrack. Anytime the NASCAR guys are there, and I believe they should get rid of most of the grass. And when you hit wet grass, you have absolutely no control of anything. Dry grass is bad enough, but wet is really bad. So, and you can't try that. So, that's just my opinion. If anybody asks,
yeah,
well, that's like hitting ice, ain't it?
Yeah, you're along for the ride, then.
Well, I know I hit ice this past year with my truck, and I was just long for the ride. There's no stopping.
None whatsoever. But anyway, Frank, we're glad you finally did get to call in tonight, and we won't keep you no longer, but appreciate you calling in, and would like to get you back on again sometime.
Anytime, be great, guys. I appreciate you having me on. It's always a pleasure to talk to you guys.
Thank you, Frank.
You too, Frank.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm, bye-bye.
All right, bye.
Frank Kimball.
Yep.
Kick that pad on just a second.
Which pad?
The air control.
What do I think about Seth Rollins? I think he's a weasel and a thief.
I don't care what Brock Lesnar thinks about me. I'm the WWE World Heavyweight Champion.
He didn't earn that championship. He stole it from me.
That will be your next champion.
You think so?
Oh, yeah.
Anybody can beat up a Cadillac.
He's going to beat Seth Rollins up like that, too.
Anybody can beat up a Cadillac.
I mean, this guy's an animal. I mean, he is.
You know, I seen that crate come out there, I said, that Cadillac's in trouble.
Because he had his axes in there. I mean, he done a number on it.
I can't believe he jerked that door off like it was a piece of paper in a notebook.
614-5553 before Brandon Jones calls in. We are here to take a phone call.
Yeah. Red, you could call and let us know, see how that other commercial played. It played
Red.
Better.
Yeah, yeah, we got Bullet in the house tonight now.
And we got Bullet.
Oh, Seth Rollins run from Brock Lesnar.
Wouldn't you?
Yeah, I would.
And congratulations again, Bullet, on your pay it forward, $500. I seen it last night on TV on Channel 9. Bullet was on Channel 9. They counted out 5 100 smackaroos.
So if he counted you out 100,
five of them.
Five of them, then you got five before, so that's 1,000, ain't it?
I think he's messed up there, Bullet, don't you?
Well, you said he got 500 last week, then he came out another 500 on Channel 9, then that's 1,000.
I like that 1,000.
Oh, okay. I just wondering if my math was right.
But I'm satisfied with what they gave me.
$500 ain't nothing to sneeze at.
No, it's not.
No? You got that thing turned up again. I want to play one more here.
How about it? That's the Jerk.
Lunatic's friend.
My brother's favorite rapper.
All right, we're back here. Boop on Wheels, Fast Eddie, Big G, Bullet, and our co-host out of Canada, Uncle D, is not with us tonight. Prayers are with him. His computer is down.
Prayers on his computer. I figured that old Rush ended up doing what he did. I said that last week, so I was a week ahead.
I didn't think he was hurt.
And he come out of that cast, didn't he, and beat him half to death.
He's an idiot.
We are waiting for Brandon Jones.
He about most of a Russian you are, Bullet.
Bullet is not a Russian.
Nope. He ain't no Russian. That's what I'm saying. He's not a Russian. Jealousy.
I know it.
That's what it's all about, jealousy. Anyway, I'm going to say something here. I got to do this one more time. People, let's go down here. It's the 45th anniversary of the Singing Echoes. Wednesday night, July the 15th through July the 18th, we're going to have some good gospel music. We're going to have good bluegrass gospel. We're going to have some good old gospel music, period. So, Wednesday night, we got the 2x2 Quartet.
Oh, yeah, that's Kelly in the group, ain't
Mr.
it?
Mr. Kelly, Jeff Kelly in the group, yeah. Mallory Lefford, Metal Lane.
Metal Lane's good, too.
That's going to be on Wednesday night. Now, Thursday night, we still got the Singing Echoes. We got Tony Gore.
We
got
to pick a night to go.
Burns family. Well, I've
got to see Mr. Everson, Reverend Everson, too.
Well, I'd like to see, I'd like to go Friday night. That's when Singing Cook's going
to
be
it's
there.
It's not that far to go either.
No.
My good buddy Tommy Venturini's listening to the show tonight, and Tommy is a wonderful person.
Hello, Tommy.
Yeah, we all need to say hello to Tom here. I like him. He's he knows how to put up the talent here for us.
That's right.
They've got a good stable of guys too. Next week's show, I can't wait to see what he's going to have lined up for next week.
Yep.
But this week, he dynamited it out here. We're just waiting on Brandon Jones to call us. Maybe Tom get him to call us in here any minute now.
Yeah.
Brandon's a young driver, but he's good. I mean, it's good.
Yeah. How old is he, does it say?
Yeah, and Tommy, you got to overlook us a little bit. Every now and then we throw a little wrestling, WWE wrestling in on the show. We got the superstars in here. Used to be a superstar, and he likes a little wrestling. Every now and then he wants to jap slap me, but I don't know. He knows better.
He keeps it up. I'm going to body slam.
Superstar's not in here.
Yeah, well, yeah, he's not in here. You're right.
Superstars, he's in Texas.
Yeah, he's a good man to hear. All right.
Go ahead. Call you live on the whoop. Go ahead.
Hello?
Hey, how's it going?
Hello, is this Brandon?
It is.
Hey, Brandon, this is Fast Eddie with Big G and Bullet. How are you?
Good, man. How are you?
Good, and we're just talking about you. What a good racer you are.
We're trying, man. We're getting better and better each week.
Oh, I know it. I watch you. I've seen you in the camping world in the trucks.
Okay.
Driving at 33?
Yes, sir.
I mean, you guys, how old are you, Brandon, if you mind me asking?
He don't want to tell you.
Hey, Brandon? Hello?
Well, we lost him.
I think we've lost him.
Hello, Brandon.
We've lost him. Hmm. Maybe Tom can get him to call back in, or maybe he'll call back in.
Yeah.
We lost him.
Must
I don't know what happened.
Connection.
What's that like, Big G, please? And I'm going to read a little
That's
bit
not
about
too good. That don't make me feel
well,
good.
You got eyes. You need to look up there.
I got it.
Brandon
got
Jones
it.
Has turned a lot of heads in the racing right, community. Here
we
he is.
We got him back. Go ahead, caller. You live on Whoop.
There we go. You got it back?
Yeah, we're here, Brandon. Go ahead.
Got a bad connection, ain't we? A
little bit.
Hey, you've been turning a lot of heads in this racing.
Yeah, man. We're got a lot of series this year for sure. Racing all over the place. Kind of all over NASCAR series and ARCA series and all kinds of stuff. So it's been a pretty good year to get our name out there.
Yeah, and K&N.
Mm-hmm. We got a little bit of everything this year.
Now Frank says he spots for you when he's not racing.
Yeah, that's right, man. He's been starting to do that for us, and it's helping, man. I mean, he's raced all these tracks, you know, multiple times and won just about every one of them. So that's been big.
He's a good person to go to, ain't he? Frank is to learn.
For sure.
That's good.
And asking him anything, he'll tell you the truth. So.
And you're in the ARCA division. You're racing with a good organization. You know what?
Man, they've had some awesome drivers come through there.
Oh man, they're wonderful people too.
Oh yeah.
Tom and Bill. Even Wendy's a nice lady.
Yeah. Yes.
And I've had her on the show. She's wonderful. I think I've never had Bill on here, but I think I've had Tom on here once.
Okay, yep.
Yeah, I think we did have Tom on here once.
And he's great. I need to get him back on here. Tom. He's listening to the show tonight.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yep. He's not missing it.
Go ahead, Big G.
If you don't care, tell us about how old are you?
I am 18. I turned 18 in February this month or this year. So I haven't been that old that long.
Well,
you ain't old at all. You're doing good too, boy. I mean, I've watched him. He can race.
Yeah, and you're from Atlanta, Georgia.
I've seen,
yes, sir.
Brandon, I've seen you and Eric Jones battle it out before racing.
Oh yeah, we've in the truck series a little bit, late models and all kinds of stuff. So
now you're not related to him, are you?
No. He's just a competition.
Yeah,
that's too bad. You're not related to him. You can really have a
no kidding.
You can have a real rivalry there, couldn't you?
Man, he's been having a great year. Also, he's been doing really good.
Yeah, he is. Now, we just got a little bit of sheet here, a little bit of stuff on you, and this, while I was looking over, you got six starts. you're doing pretty good. Four top fives and six top tens.
Yeah, man, we really haven't slipped. We haven't slipped out too much this year.
No,
I was pretty close at Winchester a couple weeks ago.
Finished third there.
Yeah, finished third. And
led 98 laps. Go ahead, Patsy.
Yeah, that was a really good day.
Brendan, do you like Winchester? I heard that's a good track to go to.
It is. That's an awesome racetrack, honestly. Indiana's been good to us, man. We've won there multiple times and it finished great there. So I think that's our little home place for sure.
How big is that track, Winchester?
Half mile.
Okay. Well, sound like me. You're a good short track racer.
Nah, it's got a lot of banking. I am.
You need to go to Bristol then.
Tracks are tough, man.
You go to Bristol, you'll be all right. You'll probably win that one.
That's right. I hope so.
All right, Brandon, do you like Atlanta's track, Atlanta Motor Speedway?
I haven't got to race there.
I thought you might have drove trucks there.
No, they changed the age, you know, to 18. You can run all tracks. So I was an 18 when that race started.
Let me ask you something here, Brandon, do you like driving the trucks?
I don't know if that's my favorite, honestly. That Xfinity car was a blast, honestly, when we got to drive that in Iowa for RCR. But I think that's the second favorite. You know, those trucks are they're pretty free and pretty loose in the corners and they haul butt. So I mean, that's always really fun to get out there and run them sideways against guys and stuff. And it's been fun so far. But I think that Xfinity car was one of the better ones for sure.
Of course, that Arca 25 is awful good.
Man, that's always a fun one too. I got a lot of fun cars this year. It's hard to say which is my favorite.
Sure, you got the Menard Pole. See here, help me out a little bit here, Brandon. You won the Menard Pole at what racetrack? Winchester?
We did, but this year we haven't gotten poles just yet.
Okay.
But Menards is on the, you know, on the car this year. They got us on a couple cars, Xfinity car and Arca car. So that's been really awesome to have those guys on board and been behind us this year.
Oh yeah,
now that's another good, you know, good race team too, race group.
Yes,
good very sponsor. Very good sponsor
to sit down and talk to and get advice from.
Yeah, I was just reading some of your stuff here about you driving the Camping World Truck Series, K&M, K&M Pre Series, the West Tour. What's the difference between East and West? Is that just the difference in just one out West, one in the East?
That's what I thought.
Yeah, pretty much. You know, they got a couple of different rules and tracks that they run, but same car and same motor and all that. So it's just a little different atmosphere. Little different tracks. They usually run more road courses out west than they do in the east.
Okay. Yeah, you know, that's what we're asking is you need to educate us a little bit on that. We're Sprint Cup people, you know, so we keep up with them in Xfinity.
Well, didn't they used to have a Busch North, Busch East, all that?
I think they did. I remember hearing about
that's
that.
Back in the day, though.
Back.
That was probably when I was your age. 18.
Same series, just updated for the most part.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Five stays a little bit. You know, he's older than a dinosaur.
I'm up there getting close to Morgan's age. Shepard.
I am Morgan's age.
Still get out there and run around.
Do what now, Brandon?
I said he can still get out there and run around a little bit, old Morgan.
He can he?
Yeah.
He done good this weekend if he hit. I think he said somebody's tire come off the car and landing on his grill and overheated.
Started overheating his car.
So he just pulled it in. Yep.
He's been having Tony Furr working with him a little bit, and he's a good crew guy. Tony Furr is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
What do you guys think about the Daytona incident?
Phew.
I'm just glad he's okay.
Austin Dillon is lucky. I mean, he's good that he's okay. Yeah.
He's fortunate.
I talked to him a couple days ago, and he said he was doing good. So,
man,
that's great. I guess did he say anything about being sore or hurting or anything?
Just a little bit. He said his tailbone hurts just a little bit, but that was the only complaint.
Well, if that's all you got to complain about, that's good.
Hey, man, that's crazy how much safety is in these cars now.
Oh, yeah. He went for a ride, didn't he, Brandon?
Oh, man.
I mean, when the engine comes out, that whole engine of his is laying on the ground on fire.
I seen that.
Yeah.
That's unreal.
It hit someone else's car, too, I think. I can't remember. But that guy was lucky, too. I think it was Matt DiBenedetto's car. It almost crashed through the windshield.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you know, you can't say whose fault it is because you can't tell what's what.
No, exactly. I mean, they just trying to go for it at the very end.
But what it looked like to me, it looked like Kevin Harvick's car clipped Denny Hamlin, and it started that chain reaction deal right there right at the end.
Yep.
Of course, my man won it, so I was glad of that. Dale Jr. Yeah.
Awesome job all day.
Oh, yeah, he drove hard out of that 88, didn't he?
Oh, man.
I'm going to send you over to Casey Kane's camp and let you tell him how to drive a car.
Oh, man.
Somebody needs to show him how to drive one.
I've watched Brandon race. He can race one. He can race one. He can drive them trucks. He can drive ARCA, and he can drive Xfinity. I've seen him do it. Boy, wouldn't you like... Go ahead, Brandon.
That's one thing we've, you know, kind of been doing every year is just staying in a big mix of series. And I think that's honestly helped, just going back and forth between, you know, each weekend.
Yeah.
We're always something new, so it's not always a surprise, you know, when you get back in it. So
yeah.
That's been something pretty big we've been doing each year.
Now, you've not done Sprint Cup yet, right?
That is the only thing I have not done. I'm probably going to hold off on that for a little bit. That's a different league right there.
That's a different animal, I guess. But I believe I believe you could do it, though. You got the right car, you can do it. That's what it's all about. Yeah. If you had the opportunity, you'd jump it, wouldn't you?
Oh, man, that'd be a blast.
Oh, yeah. I mean, anybody would, yeah.
Exactly. That's all of our dreams is to be in one of those 43 spots one day.
Yeah.
I can go out there and stand in 43rd place and say I was there.
Oh.
That's all I can do.
Big G, he can do it.
That's all I can do is stand there.
And loves, he's like me, he loves that racing.
I used to be with
his blood.
Yeah, it's in my blood bad because I used to work on a race team.
Kodak car.
Kodak car, if you remember.
Oh, yeah,
Morgan McClure.
Now.
Do what?
Said, yeah, you're in far now. You're all hooked.
Yeah. Morgan, he says he needs help, but I told him, I said, I can't drive all the way around the world to come and help you. Like I'd like to, I would, but.
If the dollar signs is right, you would.
Dollar signs have to be right.
Yeah, it's tough, man. I mean, they, you know, they did Daytona, and now they have to turn around, and I think a lot of them are testing at Kentucky this weekend on Wednesday, so it's a pretty big turnaround having to go from there to, you know, go back and forth. And
yeah, now Xfinity's going to be there Friday night, Kentucky.
Yeah. Yep.
Now, when is your next race in ARCA?
ARCA, we are racing Iowa next week, I want to say.
Yeah. Are you not racing nothing till then, or are you going to?
We're in Kentucky with the truck series this weekend.
All right.
Driving the 33 for GMS again.
Now, who is that group,
GMS?
Yes.
They are, it's called Gallagher Motorsports is what that stands for. And they've been around, you know, for a couple years here, but they've really expanded, and they've got a lot of good stuff coming for them, man, so.
That ain't Spencer Gallagher, is it?
Yeah, that's Spencer.
Oh, okay.
Part of his team.
Well. Yeah.
So they just moved shops this year, and they got a lot of brand new trucks and stuff like that. So they've really made a lot of great improvements, and it's showing. I mean, you know, he finished second in Gateway a couple weeks ago, and us at Iowa. So they're starting to come on strong here.
Oh yeah. Yeah, and you've got late model sportsman track champion at Gresham Motorsports Park.
Mm-hmm.
That
was back when we first started. That was one of our first years for racing for points there. That was a good time, man. Those little late model trucks that we ran were a blast. Honestly, we had a lot of fun with that for a couple of years, and we raced at Lanier too. I'm sure you've heard of Lanier Speedway in Georgia.
Yes.
That place is. They both closed down though this year. So.
Well, I'll be dog.
It's been kind of crazy that happened, but.
I hate to see speedways closed down.
I know, man. That was Lanier was one of the happening places for a while.
And Gresham is closed too, isn't it?
Gresham closed, yep.
Yeah, that's where KT raced at some.
Yeah.
We're talking about
Kristen Wallace.
Kristen Wallace.
Oh, yeah, she raced the trucks there a lot.
Yeah, she'd like to get a shot at the on up a little bit, and I said, yep.
Yeah, for sure.
And they say she does pretty good in them super trucks or whatever it is that she races.
She ran really good when we were there.
Yeah. And then her brother, Eric, it works with Carl, used to work with Carl. He works with Ricky Stenhouse now. Mm-hmm. He's good at racing, too.
Oh, yeah. He gets out there and runs it a little bit. And he's always a good competition. That was always a fun day racing them.
Yeah. I like to see all you guys get up there and, do what you like doing, what you love doing, and we won't see all of you getting the winner's circle. I mean, we're just NASCAR fans all the way around, Fast Eddie said, he likes Dale Jr., we got our
your Case Kane.
And I like Casey but we like, we're just NASCAR fans all around. We like everybody, you got your pick. You know what I'm saying?
But I am a Frank Kimmel and a Brandon Jones fan too.
Yeah,
because I've seen. I mean, not just because they've been on the show. I pull for them anyway. I've seen them. I know what they can do.
Yeah, you gotta have you gotta have your favorites. And Frank and Brandon.
Venturini is my ARCA team.
Yeah,
that's who all the Venturini people.
Yeah, I like all of them.
They've always got cars running up front. I mean, that's the top cars is the Venturini cars always.
You got that right.
I asked somebody one day. I said, "Well, who do you pull for? Whoever wins the race." And I said, "Well, you ain't no race fan."
No, man, you gotta have favorites.
you gotta have favorites, right? Yeah, but I'm like Fast Eddie. I like all the Venturini, people and them and. All you guys are, we think you're all are tops.
Yep, that's for sure.
And we've been doing good. I've been trying to get a little information out of Frank there, and he's been helping a ton, spot and everything. And he's been running good too at those mile and a half, man. He's been right there at the front.
Yeah. Now
he's got a lot of seconds and been close.
Are you going back to Talladega this year?
I don't remember. I don't remember who's going to be driving there.
Yeah,
I'm not 100% sure.
Don't you run each track twice or once?
What's that?
Tracks. Do you run them once or twice or some of them twice?
Only run twice.
Do you? Okay.
Yeah, there's a few that I think Iowa and Bristol and a couple of those places. They go back to Talladega.
I'd like to go see a good ARCA race.
Yeah, I would too. It's a shame that they, shut down Nashville up here in Smyrna. That'd have been a real good track for ARCA.
But
they raced the fairgrounds this year. ARCA did.
Yeah, that's right. They I think Kristen Wallace supposed to race up there this year. Or she's supposed to race up there.
Fairgrounds is a cool place. I like that racetrack. It's pretty neat to get on that.
Having
that place closed for a while, but.
Yeah, they closed it when they built the other one.
Yep.
Now, from what I've understood, Nashville Super Speedway is supposed to open back up. A group bought them.
Okay.
I forget the name of the group, but I seen it the other day. Nexavision.
Okay.
And it's supposed to be back up or going to be going again.
That'd be great.
Interesting.
But I don't know who's running there, but Dover sold the track.
Okay.
Dover Speedway. They owned the Nashville Super Speedway. Not the fairgrounds, but
these old tracks come back and everyone run at them, truck series and stuff. That'd be cool.
Yeah, I like the Rock. You know, I'm glad they opened the Rock back up. I think truck series, don't they go up there and run?
No, they did a couple years ago, but they shut it back down, I think.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good grief.
This year.
Well, I hate to hear that.
No, that was an awesome race, man, last year. Or, you know, a couple years ago, whenever they did that. That was really cool.
Well, that's a little bit.
They raced there in a late model car one time, and that was a crazy, crazy race. But
that's kind of dear to my heart, because that was my first race I was working on the crew.
The Rock?
The Rock was my first race. When they called us to work. And then I got to see Bill Elliott win his first race there. We was loading the car up and getting it all strapped in, and they wasn't that many laps left, and we was getting ready to get in the car and leave, and I said, hold on a minute, Bill just took the lead, because Bill Elliott used to be my driver back in the day, and I said, I want to watch him win this race, and I dadgum, he won it. I believe that's the last race he ever won.
Brandon, I got a question for you. What's your favorite track?
Oh, I want to say Iowa. I think it's just kind of like a mile and a half and a short track combined. You know, it's got all the speed, but then you run against someone and you get a little aero loose, aero tight. So it's got the characteristics of them all, and I think that's something really cool. Really cool there, and we've run really well there every time we've been. You know, no matter what car it's been, we finished inside the top 10 every time. So it's always been a track that has always put a smile on our face when we show up there.
Heard you say he's 18 years old. It's going to take me a while to look back when I was 18. But did you actually start out in go-karts, or did you just start racing?
No, I started in those super trucks, actually. We did that for just a few years and just kind of ran test laps for a while and just made sure we were comfortable and ran a couple races in that and then started doing some late models and K&N and things like that. So I kind of got a little late start and a little bit ahead of everyone else when we first started out, but starting to even off a little bit.
Well, you're a fine young man. It's nice talking to you, and I'll turn you back over to Fastead.
Yeah.
All right, buddy. It was good talking to you.
Yeah. What are you up to tonight, Brandon? Just getting ready for your next race here? Or?
Yeah, just getting ready for Kentucky. We're going to fly out tomorrow morning, and they've got tech that day, and then it's a one-day show on Thursday for us. So
look for the 33, right, Brandon?
That's right.
I'll be looking for it. Get you a good qualifying setup, and let's do it. That's what I look at.
Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. I want to hear your name in lights.
So it's just two.
Right, man, I hope so.
Two more nights, two more days, and you'll be racing, right?
That's right. We'll be out there, and hopefully, like you guys said, we'll be getting the lights and the water sprayed on us, sir.
There you go.
Yeah, now that's a night race. I hope.
Yes, night race.
Yeah, that'd be good.
That'll be cool.
Yeah, it will be.
We don't get to watch them, I don't think. They show them. They tape the limb, I think, don't they?
No, they'll show that. They're going to show that truck race live.
Oh yeah,
they?
The truck race, the ARCA races. They don't.
Yeah.
Not all of them.
Not all of them.
Yeah, I wish they would. But
I know, man. Those are some good races.
Yeah. Well, Brandon, buddy, it's good having you, and we got Cody Coughlin coming on next. So, we want to see at Gatorade. Spraying and slanging and water and And you'd be up there on top of that truck throwing high fives.
That's the plan.
All right, buddy.
Good luck to you, Brandon.
All right, guys. Thanks for having me on.
All right, buddy.
We'll get you back.
Right. See ya.
Yeah,
all right. Bye-bye.
Bye. All right. That was Brandon Jones, Venturini Motorsports. Great kid there, Bullet.
I'm not used to saying young man because I consider myself, I used to be young, but I'm not now.
You just as young as you want to be. You know, everybody can't be dinosaurs like Eddie, but he's a dinosaur.
Yeah. You said that, I did.
Nah, I tell him all the time he's a dinosaur. But he was great guy there. I enjoyed talking to him. Okay.
So be watching it.
All right. We're ready for him. There he is. Caller, you live on Whoop.
Hey, this is Cody Coughlin. How are you?
All right, Cody. You got Big G, Fast Eddie, and a Bullet here in the house. how you doing?
Great. Just enjoying a evening here in Ohio and getting excited to go truck racing this Thursday.
Well, what kind of weather you got up there?
Up there with our company, Jags, and really excited to be working up there with them and just kind of relaxing tonight.
I heard that there.
Hey, Cody, will you be, what number will you be, 25, right?
Yeah, we're going to be at 25, which is, got a lot of history with Venturini, so excited about that.
Oh, yeah, that's used to be the Justin Boston truck, wasn't it?
Well, it used to be Bill Senior's car, too.
Oh, yes.
Wow.
Yeah, that's good. And then in the ARCA series, you drive the 55, don't you?
That's right.
Yeah. Well, you couldn't ask for no better group to work with Venturini. You know what?
Yeah, they're great.
Good group of guys to be with.
Yeah, they got a lot of experience, and it's always good to work with them.
You got that right. Hey, Cody, what got you started into racing? Can you tell us?
Yeah, my parents and my uncles always drag raced for a long time. My parents just being my dad, obviously, but, my mom would go with them and whatnot. And, that's how our company was started at Jag, through the drag strips with my grandpa Jag, and then trickled down to my uncles and my father. And so I kind of wanted to follow in the same steps, but I just wanted to, I guess, stay in the car a little bit longer. That's why I chose circle track, I guess.
Yeah. I like drag okay, but it takes a – I don't know it as good as I do this.
Yeah, it's all about getting that last thousandth of a second out of the car. It's so close. So definitely really close competition.
Yes, very good.
Yeah, that this Big G you got here, Cody, we're just talking to Brandon and all them, Jones and can't wait to see you guys get out there. I guess you'll be out there with him this week, right?
Thursday.
That could very well be. I'm not sure if he's racing trucks or not, but
yeah, he is.
Oh, he is. Well, that'll be cool. And yes, we'll be both out there, and it'll be fun.
All right. Well, that'd be the two trucks we'll be watching.
Well, that'll be great. We appreciate it.
We'll be watching you and him just go at it out there.
That's right. That's the plan. Good fun racing, and hopefully we both have good runs.
Now, when you go to the track, you might be friends, but that goes out the window, don't it, when you start racing?
Well, you always try and race everybody as hard as you can and as clean as you can.
Yeah.
Hope to get a win, that's the mindset you take to every race.
Yeah, you got to, yeah.
Yeah, now, how long have you been racing these trucks?
Well, this is my first truck race, so this will be a real neat moment for me.
Great, great. Congratulations.
Yes.
Thank you.
So, I watched Darrell Wallace Jr. last couple of years when he was racing in the truck race, and that right there is a man can really get it on, too, in one of them trucks.
Yeah, he's done well.
Hey, Cody, your ARCA stats for this year, this is what I like. six starts, two top fives, and three top tens. And you finished fourth at Daytona. And season's best second place at Talladega, and won the pole at Talladega in Chicago.
Yeah, you know, we probably should have about six top fives on there. You know, we've ran really well everywhere. We've just had a couple just bad luck situations the last couple of weeks that took us out of, you know, getting those good top fives and contentions for wins. So, you know, that stat really doesn't even show how good we've been running. So, and it's still pretty good. So that's,
yeah, it is. Very good. You like road courses? I see you drove that New Jersey road course.
Yeah, I do. It was a lot of fun. It was something different and changed it up, and it was fun shifting all the time, and I actually enjoyed it.
Cody, how old are you, if you mind asking?
19, so.
Oh, yeah.
Pretty young yet, I would think.
Yeah, yeah. Got a long racing career, ain't he, Big G?
Got a long one.
For sure, yep. That's cool.
Hope he wins many championships.
And you are the Joe Gibbs development driver.
That's correct. So that's really exciting to be with them. I mean, there's no better organization. So really cool.
Yeah. Coach Gibbs is a good guy. Me and Five Cities met him. Was it last year?
Yeah.
Last year
at Talladega. Nice fella.
Real nice
guy. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Great. He's a super guy. Great role model.
JD, he's a good guy, too. I met him before too. He's real nice, but I think JD's more or less got the handle on taking everything over with pretty much now. Joe's just, I think, enjoying the winning, and because you can't get a smile off his face.
Right. They win a lot, so that's the good part.
Yeah.
Now, when you do the development driving, Cody, do you drive, what, is their car the 20 car in that?
They have the 20, the 54, and the 18, and the Xfinity, and then they got the 19, 18, 11, and 20 in the Cup Series.
Yeah. But you drive Xfinity and trucks with them, right? Or you drive trucks with Venturini?
This is my first truck race with Venturini, so it's going to be really excited to make the debut.
Yes.
I haven't done any Xfinity stuff yet.
Yeah, but that'll happen.
Well, we hope so, for sure.
Yeah, I hope it does, too, on you. You know, get out there and get the experience. More you experience is what they call it. You know, more you do it, the better you get.
That's right.
And now, do you do any testing for any of them?
Well, they banned testing in NASCAR for the most part. I think there's, you know, a couple exceptions, obviously, with sanctioned tire tests and whatnot, but so no, for the most part, I wouldn't be doing any of that.
Okay, I didn't know if you might do some, if the Xfinity does any of it or not.
I haven't done any of it, no.
Okay. Well, that right there gives you some experience if they did it.
It would be nice, for sure.
Yeah. I don't know why that they had banned testing. I thought that right there was, especially, you know, tires, or, you know, going testing tires, I guess it's cause money.
Mm-hmm.
Costs a lot more money to do it, and they're trying to keep costs down. I know everything's going up.
Yeah, for sure.
Let's see. You come in seventh in Winchester, right, Speedway?
In the ARCA car?
Let me see here. I might be reading.
Winchester Labor Day race, and then we finished seventh in the ARCA race last year.
Okay, that was last year. Okay, then 2000 Daytona in 2015, fifth at Chicagoland 2014. This year second. Yeah,
that's right.
Okay, I was making sure my cheat sheet's right.
That's right.
You know, us people that talk to you, we got to make sure our cheat sheets are right, where we don't look well. Well, we don't sound like a bunch of dummies.
Yeah.
Okay, now, after 2011, Howdy, Rookie of the Year in the Jags, CRA All-Star Tour. He ran a limited schedule in 2012, but came back full tilt in 2013, earning the Jags CRA All-Star Tour Championship.
Yeah, that was really exciting. That was cool to win the championship and fortunate enough to do it.
Well, that's great. Just what I've read here, you are full of talent.
Well, we really appreciate that, and thank you very much for saying so. We work hard at it, for sure.
Yeah. Now, did you just get started and just going out there and start racing? You did it, ever since you were 5 year old, or when they let you in a car?
I was about 10 in the quarter midget, so that's how I got my start.
Well, that's good. That's a long time. So you've been 19, started when you was 10.
Yeah.
9 years. Cool. That's nine years, pretty good experience.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, for sure.
Now, I wasn't in here just a second ago, but when did you start? You started when you was 10, and what did you start?
Quarter midgets.
Okay. That's a good little deal to start out with, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure. You learn how to do it, and that's all you can do is learn.
There's something, I think it was last week, me and Fastead had, I can't remember who it was on the show, but they run go-karts, I think it was, and
yeah.
They said they didn't have seat belts or roll cages in them.
Oh, that's pretty wild. I've never seen anything like that.
I haven't either. I think this is might have been up in Canada. We was interviewing somebody up in Canada, and they said when they was running, they didn't have roll cages or seat belts. And I thought,
the girl in the go kart.
Girl in the go kart, right? It's a female in the go kart. They said they'd rather for them to try to kick the go kart off of them than it would be them to stay in it. And I thought, well, what if another go kart runs over top of you?
Yeah, that wouldn't be good. That would definitely hurt.
Cody, did you watch that Sprint Cup race where Austin Dillon went into the catch fence?
I did. Thank God he's all right.
Yeah.
That was a terrible situation, and that just speaks volumes on how much safety's come along.
Oh, man.
Mm-hmm.
It sure has.
Yep.
That's the good thing.
And not bringing up bad memories, Darrell Earnhardt Jr. didn't take a lick, nothing like, not junior, but senior. Didn't take a lick, nothing like what he took.
Right, exactly. That's true.
I think he's been three or four wrecks like that, Cody, and I think Austin's in the books on that one of the real bad wrecks like that.
I think he's got Brett, not Brett, but the other Bo down. I think he got him beat.
For sure. But, that's speaks volumes to the safety that they've made, and really excited to go race that truck this Thursday and hopefully get a good finish.
I hope you get a good finish there and get up there and just have a good time too and be safe.
Well, I really appreciate that from you guys, and I appreciate you guys having me on as well.
Right, and we appreciate having you and want to get you back on sometime. All right.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much.
Thank you too, Cody. Good luck at Kentucky. And he's gone.
He has left the building.
Yep.
Guys, last time I saw a wreck that bad was when Richard Petty and Michael Waltrip had a bad wreck.
Michael Waltrip had a bad wreck.
And Richard Petty, everybody thought he got killed.
Yes.
Michael Waltrip, that's one you talking about when he had to climb out of the car, out of the roof of it?
Yeah.
Number 30?
Yeah.
And Richard Petty had his wreck, I can't remember when, it was back in the 80s, I think, wasn't it?
I think so. And
I think his wife said, are you through? I can't remember what she said about it now. She made a statement. She said, are you having fun yet? Or something.
He probably said, yeah. He probably said, yeah, I'm having the ball.
I tell you, there's been some bad wrecks. I don't understand Dale Earnhardt's wreck, though, because to me it looked like he didn't hit the wall that hard. But
it was his time to go.
There was so much speculation went on that, and I really don't want to talk a whole lot about it because I don't know. I'm just saying this was just speculation. They said Dale had a bad habit of unloosening his seatbelt before the race was over.
And his helmet, too.
I don't even think he had a harness to buy.
No, they didn't have They had a few of them had Hans.
He wore goggles.
He wasn't the old, yeah, the old motorcycle type helmet. What he wore was goggles. But, you know, that was just one of the speculations. They said that that when the crew members got up there, his seatbelt wasn't, you know, tight. But, you know, he could have wrecked and still could have been alive trying to get out. Then, you know, boom.
Did you guys watch that race?
Yeah, I did.
I did too. And it was, of course, I was sad about it.
Well, I was too, especially the comment I made before it happened. But I was just going on because, you know, I didn't ever pull for Dale Earnhardt. But, you know, I'm sad because Dale Earnhardt's gone. He's one that made racing.
What I'm sad about, it seemed to me like he's just getting his life started. And then it just ended.
We got a phone call, Big
Chief. We got a phone call there first, did he? Go ahead, call you live on Whoop.
Oh, and is Uncle D ever glad he made it in for the last few minutes of Whoop on Wheels tonight?
Uncle D.
What are you doing down there in Cleveland, Tennessee?
Oh, we've had a well of a show, Uncle D.
Well, I'm looking forward to seeing it on YouTube tomorrow, and all for the last 3 hours, I feel like I've been playing hooky from school. I've missed it being on the show. And,
oh, I've missed you, Uncle D.
Maybe mention that Uncle D's. I've got no access to my Facebook. I don't know why. I'm the only one, and I'm the administrator, and yet everybody else seems to use it. But my technician wasn't able to drop by. But hopefully we'll be up and on the go again. Hopefully by noon tomorrow. But it's interesting, I caught the back half of Cody's interview there, and he was noting that he's going to be involved in his first Camping World Series race, and so I wish him all the best. And I think, Fast Eddie, I let you know, too, this morning when we were chatting, that Uncle D is going to be in his first race this Friday night at Full Throttle Motor Speedway in a truck, a little mini truck. And I'm so excited. So, yeah. And
I know, I see a picture of it, number one. It's teal. It's beautiful. Project Track Champion on it. And
Uncle D's going to be racing in tribute for my Amy Lynn Moore from Jasper, Georgia, and who's now in heaven, along with all the other little angels that are up there in heaven who spent their time with us here on Earth, but then God called them home. Be it from an illness or whatever. And so, yeah, Uncle D will be racing for the little angels in heaven on Friday night.
Now, Uncle D, the number one truck, whose truck is that? Is that Gord's?
We actually, Gord and I are splitting. It's going to be like a cross promo on it. But Gord Bennett, yes, the owner of Full Throttle Motor Speedway. Yeah, we went halves on that truck to promote both Full Throttle Motor Speedway, located in Varney, Ontario, Canada, along with Project Track Champion, Project Track Champion Access Motorsport Racing. And, of course, that's all about Uncle D's world and the world of those having disabilities and illnesses. So, yeah, it's. I posted some pictures of the truck, and it got a lot of hits on it. There's a lot of excitement. And her dear mother, Dana, down there in Jasper, Fast Eddie and Bullet, and I see Gerald just left the studio there. Her mother is just so elated that even way up here in Canada, hundreds of miles away from where her daughter is resting there in Jasper, Georgia, of course we know she's in heaven.
Yes.
But she is just so delighted that her daughter's life had such an incredible impact on everyone she met, and certainly in Uncle D's life. And, she was a blessing. She is still a blessing. And I tell people, Amy's still around. I see my Amy every time I see something beautiful. From a flower growing and the birdie singing, Amy's smile is there, just like all the other folks, like Dizzy Coleman and so many other of our little angels that were here and now are in heaven. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes, you're right. And, Uncle D, Big G has been running the controls tonight here.
Yes, when I first saw the studio cam there, I said, I'm thinking, well, whose back of the head is that? And because I usually, I seldom ever see the back of Big G's head.
That's bald, ain't it?
Yeah. It looked kind of cute.
That right there is gray hair. Because I have to put up this idiot across from me.
Listen,
here.
Oh, no.
I'm so anxious to hear tonight's show, and I'll see it on YouTube. I'm sure that you had a great time with Frank Gemmell Sr. He's just he's a living legend.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do what? No. I don't need that. He's talking to me here, and I don't need that. There's a trash can there.
Yeah.
But anyway, Uncle D, it's I appreciate Tom Venturini setting this show up. He done a wonderful job, and he's gonna have another stellar dynamite show. We will next Tuesday night with Venturini's.
Yes.
Then we're gonna slip it over for the next 2 weeks. TriStar Motorsports.
Perfect. Well, it looks like we got some more exciting programs here Tuesday night and Whoop on Wheels. For our listeners around the world, we certainly do appreciate those that do drop by and to listen in on the show. And I know that Fast Eddie and Big G do their best to present a good, informative, and exciting show every Tuesday night. And like Fast Eddie has probably already said, to be sure you catch it on YouTube tomorrow. It'll be posted tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah.
But in the meantime, Uncle D is going to try and get dry here. It's been a drizzly day all day here on Ontario, Canada. And so we want to make sure that everything is nice and dry by Friday night. We got a tractor pull going on this weekend at Full Throttle Motor Speedway. So Uncle D is quite excited about that as well, too. So, but in any case, it's good to see you guys. I'm so glad I was able to squeak in a call here, and I want to wish you all a safe week, and God bless you all.
Hey, Uncle D, before you go, are you all going to qualify for your position Friday night, or draw straws, or how are we doing that?
I think based on good looks alone, that it was a given as far as.
You're going to the poll, huh?
He won in the qualifications.
Mm.
I'm not really too sure how they're going to do it. Being that I'll be the oldest of the gang, I'm sure that there'll be some respect shown towards the elder by probably just awarding him P1 to get the races started.
Now, when they drop the flag, open it wide open, Uncle D. I want to see a winner out of you.
Did you say drop the flag?
I said when they drop the green flag, I want you to be leading that race.
Well, we will certainly do our best. And we've got a good flagman, Carl, there at the senior flagman there at Full Throttle. And he hasn't dropped a flag yet. At least not on the track where he's had to stop the race and get out of the
track. Uncle D thinks dropping the flag is just drop the flag down. You know, it's going to be a long night up there in Ontario.
Hey, Uncle D is on his way, so do take care of you all, and we'll catch you next Tuesday night on Whoop on Wheels.
I need you to get ready for August, too.
Yeah, you got it.
You got some lineups for August?
We can certainly get on that ASAP, and we will have some Canadian really good folks to be on the show, guaranteed.
I got one I want you to get for me, and he's not Canadian. Kenny Wallace.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, Kenny and I, we're good buddies. And as you know, Kenny has driven the Project Track Champion car. And when he was done running around the track up there at Sauble Speedway, I said, Kenny, I said, you're the first NASCAR driver to wheel the Project car. He said, yes. He said, I know that my brother Rusty has actually sat in the car, but he said, I actually get the wheel. So I said, what do you think of the car? He said, of course, he gave his usual Kenny Wallace remark. It was awesome.
Yeah, and see if you can work on that for August.
I'll certainly do that. I'll get a hold of Kim and his wife, and I'm sure we can get something going to get Kenny on the show then in August.
Sounds like a winner.
All righty.
Hey, God bless.
Take care.
Bye. We'll be talking.
See you.
All right. Uncle D out of Canada.
Canada, Uncle D.
You can't beat him, really. Shirley was missed tonight on the Whoop on Wheels.
Whoop. How does he say whoop?
Same way he says Oregon.
Oregon.
Whoop.
We have 10 minutes left, Big G. 614-555-3. Go ahead, caller.
Is this Eddie?
Yeah.
I want to know where you get your music at.
Do you like it?
No, I don't.
It gets it out of his back pocket.
Why do you not?
That figures. Go ahead.
Why do you not have racing music on there?
Well, I like to play a little Doc Hollywood music. Bee Gees, Donna Summer.
That don't sound right for a race show.
He took all my music away from me. I'm just redheaded stepchild.
Redheaded stepchild. No, well, I'm
stepchild.
He looks like a gray mule to me. Gray mare. He's going to come across the table.
I'm fishing to whoop, get a can of whoop, you know, on you in a minute.
Oh, my goodness.
Go ahead. Beat him up.
Why do you say that, Red?
Well, you keep picking on him.
Hey, Red, did you hear?
Did you pick on me?
Did you hear our commercial a while ago? Did it sound any better that
it
last time?
It sounded a little bit better, but still a little bit low.
Huh. Well, don't know why.
You may have to go back and redo them.
Might have
and turn
to.
Your volume
you
up.
You could hear it, Eddie, but it just wasn't real loud.
Yeah,
not loud like the other ones are.
We got Bullet in the house.
Bullet and I, me and Bullet don't talk anymore.
Oh.
Did you just break up?
Well, he went back to Mark Grisham.
Oh, he
went back to Mark Grisham.
Yeah.
I understand he didn't do that now. He's gone.
No, he's back with Mark Grisham, so I hope they'll be very happy together.
Okay. Well, I didn't know that.
That's another love fest I didn't know about. I mean, I'm sorry. No, that's another fest I didn't know about. I have to aggravate this crew in.
So you're not speaking to Bullet?
No.
Okay.
I thought he was going to not go back to Mark Grisham, but he did. And I don't like that man.
Well,
I hate that.
Why do you hate that?
Did you hear my voice? I hate that.
Sarcasm. Insulted me on the radio, so I won't have nothing to do with him or anybody that does.
Sarcasm. You hear the sarcasm in my voice?
Oh, yeah.
You say, boy, I really
I know
hate
it
that.
Tore you up, Big G.
It did. I can't hardly stand. I'm about to cry like Eddie has all night long.
Hey, Red, we're going to have Superstar back in here in a couple of months.
When?
I don't know yet. I've got to get Big G to get a hold of him in Texas.
Let me know when he's going to be down there.
He'll be here.
I won't see him in person this time.
All right, you can. He has a red, he's dressed in red and black.
I know. I've got his picture.
My gosh, he's mean looking.
He is.
But the next time he comes in here, I'm going to jap slap him.
But I think he's plumb pretty myself.
Do you think I can whoop him?
No.
The Superstar?
He'd tear you up, Eddie.
God. Okay.
He about swallowed his own medicine right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, that's for sure.
Just one slap and you'll be gone, Eddie. Better leave him alone.
He can't win for losing, can he?
No. I'm so, sorry, Eddie. I pick on you all the time.
So when we have the Superstar back, you want to see him?
Yes, I'm going to come down there and see him.
Well, that'd be fine.
I won't bother him or nothing. I just want to look at him.
Or you can bother him.
Oh, I can? Oh, boy.
Yeah, because now he'll fight. He loves to fight.
He wouldn't fight me.
I don't say that, Red. I believe he would.
No, he wouldn't.
Well, me and Bullet both was a little scared when he came in here last time.
I'm not scared of him.
I want Big G to hang around for him this time, too.
I don't know if I want to hang around much. You say how big he is.
I can still whoop him, but I think.
Eddie, you can't whoop him.
Who can't?
You can't.
How do you know?
I just know you can't. I've seen you and I've seen him, and you can't whoop him.
Do you think Big G could whoop him? No.
I don't know that. Big G's a pretty big guy.
He can't whoop the Superstar.
I don't know. It might be a pretty good fight.
Hmm.
Well, we might have to see sometime, might we?
Well, yeah.
And Big G won't back down from him.
I know.
I won't either.
We might have to go out here in this
hallway. I won't back down from him, but he may back me down. Right down out of that chair.
Eddie, you wouldn't back down from him, but you'd run like the devil.
No, I was in here with him. But I watched my P's and Q's the whole time.
Well, didn't you go to a wrestling match and was going to wrestle one night and you took off because somebody body slammed you or something?
I didn't take off. I was going to wrestle and I got slammed by the junkyard dog and that was it.
Well, see.
I found out the hard way this is not the profession I wanted.
So you better leave the other one alone then.
Yeah, I mean, he slammed me. I almost went through the mat.
I'd love to have seen that.
Yeah,
I like seeing it too.
It hurt my back.
I believe I took a video.
And I
of
think
that.
He absorbed some of the fall too.
Okay, I'm gonna let y'all go.
All right,
see you, Red.
Right.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, turn that thing back on again. The air control. Hey, turn that thing back on. Voices in my head, they counsel me. Air control. They understand. Hey, they talk to me. That's Superstar.
The Superstar.
But anyway, Big G.
You guys remember the Superstar used to be down here at the auditorium? He was about 6'5", and he had black hair come out of his mask. I don't know who he was, but he went by the Superstar.
Superstar.
That's who you're looking at. All right. Hey, Big G, it was wonderful tonight. You done a wonderful job.
I got used to it. I was done all right.
We'll get you back on it another time one of these days.
Yeah, another 4 months.
Another 4 months and a half. How's that? Yeah. We'll stretch it another half.
Then I'll forget the other half of it.
No, we'll get you back. We'll get you back on the board before then.
You know what he's training for, don't you, Big G?
Yeah, he's leaving.
Yeah, he's on vacation.
Yeah, he's vacating.
No, he's going to leave. You just said it. We're going to turn it over to Big Gene Bullet to run the Whoop on Wheels.
Whoop on Wheels.
All right, till next week.
Yep. Everybody, have a wonderful week. What's left of it. God bless you. And
God bless the USA,
God
too.
God bless USA, and thank God for Mr. Dillon didn't get hurt.
And the troops.
And the troops. We got to think about America.
We got a lot of them coming home, a lot of them still there.
This America is going downhill,
and that's a good way to put it.
But anyway,
we'll see you next Tuesday night. We'll have another Venturini show. Tom will be getting with me shortly, another day or two or something, and we'll have some more Venturini guys or gals on here. So until next week,
yep. God bless
the USA. God bless each and every listener on the Whoop. Good night.
You are listening to WOOP-LP, Cleveland, Tennessee. Whoop FM is a broadcasting service of the Traditional Music Resource Center, and we play America's original music.
Check into Check Into Cash.
Turn your car into cash at Check Into Cash.
Get an auto title loan today for up to $2,500.